Good morning, students. How are you? Okay, fine. Already we have started the problems, that is nothing but exercise from NCERT. Six problems we have completed. The last problem we have completed, the resistivity of a given material of the wire. The answer we have obtained for that, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ohm meter. That is the last problem for us yesterday. The continuation of the problem, the next problem, seventh problem. I hope that yesterday I understood the problem. So I go for seventh problem. Continuation of that yesterday's class, problem class. The seventh problem, what he has mentioned, a silver wire has a resistance of 2.1 ohm. A silver wire has a resistance of 2.1 ohm at 27.5 degree centigrade. At 27.5 degree centigrade. And a 27.5 degree centigrade. And a resistance of a resistance of 2.7 ohm at 100 degree centigrade. Determine the temperature coefficient. Of resistivity of silver. Now this is the problem. A silver wire has a resistance of 2.1 ohm at 27.5 degree centigrade and a resistance of 2.7 ohm at 100 degree centigrade. Determine the temperature coefficient of resistivity of a silver. When you are going to observe the problem, it has got the two resistance corresponding to temperatures. Then it is going to ask that temperature coefficient of a given material of the wire, that is a silver. So I go for the solution. After seeing the problem, what are the given things? Just to understand it, I call the lower resistance R1, 2.1 ohm, corresponding temperature T1, 27.5 degree centigrade, and higher resistance R2 after heating, 2.7 ohm, and T2 is 100 degree centigrade. Is it clear? Then I want to calculate temperature coefficient of a resistivity of a given material of the wire. When there are two temperature and two resistance, we know that let direct formula alpha equals to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 T2 minus T1. Now this is our formula. The same formula is obtained in the resistivity, temperature coefficient of resistivity of material. The change in resistivity rho suffix T equals to rho naught 1 plus alpha T minus T naught. T is the higher temperature and T naught is the lower temperature. That is our original equation. R is directly proportional to rho. That equation is modified, then become across alpha. Then simply you substitute the values. Alpha. What is R2? 2.7. What is R1? 2.1. Then R1, 2.1. T2, 100. Minus 27.5. Just check it. Then after that, follow the necessary mathematical step. 2.7 minus 2.1, 0.6. Shall I write 2.1? 100 minus 27.5 into 100 minus 27.5, or make it up 5, 8, 2, carry 1, 3, 7, that is 72.5. This is nothing but 74.5. Is it clear? Then after that, alpha equals to, shall I write 6/21? That one get cancels, both the sides. Then 72.5. Then is it cancelled by 3? 3 2s are, 3 7s are, then 72.5. So after doing the necessary calculation, 2 divided by 7 into 72.5, then I write alpha equals to 2 divided by 7 5s are 35, 3 carry, 7 2s are 14, 14 plus 3, 17, carry 1. 7 7s are 49, 49 plus 1, 50. That is 507.5. 2 divided by 507.5. So, after doing the calculation, we get alpha is a 0.0039. Alpha equals to how much? 0.00039. Now this is obtained from the calculation. Roughly, if I don't go for the calculation, this is 0.0039 is nothing but 0.004. If I want the calculator, you go for 2 divided by 507.5. Then I make it 507.5 is nearly equals to what? Shall I take nearly equals value? 500 without calculator, that is nothing but nearer value for this one. If you go for CT and other things, shall I take 2 divided by 507.5? I take roughly, 507 is nearly equal, so I take 500 round figures. Multiply by 2, divided by 2, how much? 4 by 1000. Is it nothing but 0.004 per degree centigrade? Is that answer nearer to 0.0039? On the calculator in the examination, the calculator is allowed. You go for 2 divided by 507.5, then you get it 0.0039. In the case of CET, the same thing is going to be obtained. Then, without calculator, how can you get the answer? That is nearer answer for 0.0039 is nothing but it is round figure 0.004. Both the things are same, right? Without calculator, you can follow this one. With calculator, we can go for this method. Right? Then both answers are same. 0.0039 is nothing but 0.004. Now this is our solution for the given problem. Just glance the problem. Is it clear? There are the two resistances corresponding to two temperatures. One is lower temperature, another is higher temperature. Our aim is to calculate the temperature quotient of a resistor of a silver wire. When there are two temperature and two resistance, we have got the equation alpha equals to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 T2 minus T1. Direct substitution. Then you substitute the values, go for calculation, follow the necessary steps, easy steps, then you go for this. Now this is the final requirement of. Up to this much, we don't need the calculator here. Then we need the calculator if you want to have the accurate answer. So, nearer answer without calculator, if you consider this 507 is nearly equals to 500, then you go for this is without calculator method. That the same answer as that of with calculator. Is it clear? Yes. Let me go for next. Next problem. Eighth problem. I think that you are following. So last class we have started the problem. Almost all the problems in the NCERT exercise problems are easy. Examination, for the annual examination, he is going to be set the problem from the exercise only. Sometimes he keeps the data as it is. Sometimes there is a small change in the data, but the method of solving the problem is same. Then I go for next problem. A storage battery, that is nothing but 8th problem. 8 storage battery. A storage battery of EMF 8 volt. Of EMF 8 volt. And internal resistance 0.5 ohm. And internal resistance. Internal resistance 0.5 ohm. Is being charged by a 12 volt DC supply. Is being charged by a, how much? Sorry, it is 120 volt DC supply. Charged by a 120 volt DC supply. Using a series resistor, using a series resistor, what is the value for that one? 15.5 ohm. Yes, given 15.5 ohm. Then, what is the terminal voltage of the battery? What is the terminal voltage of the battery? During charging. Then one more thing is asking that, what is the purpose of, what is the purpose of having series resistor? What is the purpose of having series resistor in the charging circuit? In the charging circuit. Now this is our problem. Right? So according to the problem, he has got the a storage battery of EMF 8 volt and internal resistance 0.5 ohm is being charged by 120 volt DC supply using a series resistor of 15.5 ohm. What is the terminal voltage of the battery during the charging, and what is the purpose of having the series resistor in the charging circuit? Now this is our problem. I go for the solution for that. So I have got a battery of how much having EMF? EMF 8 volt. Is being charged by how much? 120 volt. By using what? Series resistance. What is the value for series resistance? R equals to 15.5 ohm. And it is having the internal resistance 0.5 ohm. Right? So the battery is being charged. That is the beautiness of what? The problem. Then what is the potential difference established across the ends of the conductor? Now here, now this is the EMF E and the battery EMF is small e, it. When both the cells are connected positive to positive, there is an opposing action. Which one is greater here? The charging 120 volt. Which one is lesser here? 8 volt. It is being charged with the help of the source, 120 volt. When the cells are connected in opposite order, then the total voltage, that is nothing but, I go for voltage applied. This is nothing but voltage applied. I take V. Then the total EMF, there is opposing action. Then shall I write V minus E? Positive, positive. If the cells are connected in series, positive of the one cell, the negative of the one cell goes to next positive of the other cell, then the cells are in series, then the total EMF equals to sum of the EMF of the individual cells. But here the cells are connected in opposite order. Hence, the resultant EMF decreases. That is nothing but minus 120 minus 8. How much? 120 volt. Now this is the total EMF obtained in the circuit during the charging process. Now this is the higher voltage and it is being charged a battery of storage battery of 8 volt. That is it. Then the current in the circuit I equals to total EMF divided by, I write it, total EMF ET. The total EMF divided by total resistance R plus R, 112 volt divided by R, what is that? 15.5. What is small r? 0.5. 112 divided by 16. Can you cancel the terms? Right? What is that? 112 divided by 16. So 16, shall I make it? Divided by 2 method or 16 into 7, because last number is 2. 6 sevens are 42. 4 carry. 7 on the 7. 7 plus 4. 11. Shall I cancel directly? How to guess it? If I multiply with the 7, I get the 42. Last number is 2. I require this one. 16 ones are 16 7. No need of the calculator. Then the current in the circuit is 7 ampere. Then check the equation. See it clear. Then what is the requirement here? What is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? So when I come across the equation, now this is the circuit, Ohm's law applied to the circuit. Now this is the current. Current is drawn from the cell. Now this is called discharge. Then what we have written? Total EMF E equals to V plus V dash, then E equals to V plus I into R. Then potential difference terminal E minus I R. Is it clear? E minus I R. So I take here EMF E, EMF of the cell. I have EMF E. Right? So I make this easy according to the equation. But here we are not drawing the current from the cell, we are giving the current to the cell. Now this is what process? It is reverse. It is being charged. It is being what? Discharged. It is discharging condition. Now it is charging condition. Now charging condition. Is it the reverse of discharging? Now it becomes what? Charging. The current is given to the battery. Then it is charging. So everything will be reversed. Minus. This is minus. When it is shifted here, it becomes what? Plus. Now this is my potential difference. Shall I go it? So, what is the terminal voltage of the battery during the charging? Terminal voltage. Terminal voltage of the battery during charging. Charging. During the charging. Shall I write small e? I don't want to be confused. Capital V is taken for what? The source which is used for charging the battery. So V equals to, according to this equation, shall I write E plus IR? V. What is the EMF of the cell? 8 plus 7 into, what is the 8 ohm resistance? 0.5. So 8 plus 3.5. What is that? 8 plus 3, 11.5 volt. This is my answer. During discharging condition, EMF is greater than potential difference. But the charging condition, the EMF is lesser than the potential difference. Potential difference is greater than the EMF. Now this is the process of what? Charging. So during the charging, what is the terminal potential difference across the storage battery? That is 11.5 volt. Now this is my answer. Observe it carefully. What the theory tells? The theory tells the EMF is greater than potential difference during the condition of when the current is drawn from the cell. That is nothing but discharging condition. But this is nothing but charging condition. Then what is the reverse of that one? In charging condition, the potential difference is greater than EMF. The potential difference, that is, okay, 11.5 is greater than EMF, K2. So it means that your answer is correct. Whenever you get the solution for the problems, if you want to tally the answers, you go for verification with what? Theoretical section, what you have read. That is the things while solving the problem. If you use this technique, you feel that the problems are more easier than theoretical section, because the problems are the byproduct of what? Theory. Whatever the things we have understood in the theory, that should be once again represented in the systematic form problem while solving the problem. Is it clear? Yes. Shall I move for the next problem? Excellent, we have completed the 6 problems. Now 7 problems already have completed. Now this is the 8th problem, simplest form. Now this is the charging condition. Shall I go for the next? Yes. I go for next problem. Are you following or not? Okay sir, we are following. So with the cool mind, without any tension, we are following the problems. So problems are very easy. Please listen. When you are going to be spent this month, we are very happy. I'm not doing anything. Whatever the things which is available in the theoretical section, that should be brought systematically while solving the problem. So let me go for next problem. In a potentiometer experiment. In a potentiometer experiment, a cell of EMF 1.25 volt. 1.25 volt gives a balance point. Gives a balance point 35 centimeter length. 35 centimeter length of the wire. If the cell is replaced. If the cell is replaced, whatever the earlier cell, he has got 1.25, he has got the null point, balancing point 35 centimeter, then he replaces the another cell, and balance shift to 63 centimeter. Is that what? 63 centimeter. 63 centimeter. Full stop. What is the EMF? What is the EMF of the second cell? No, this is our problem. Here a potentiometer experiment, a cell of EMF 1.25 volt gives a balance point of 35 cm length of the wire. If the cell is replaced and balance shift to 63 cm, what is the EMF of the second cell? Whatever the number of seconds taken by writing the problems, its solution is lesser than that. There are two cells corresponding to balancing length. We know that the potentiometer principle V is directly proportional to M. For the comparison of EMF, the V is replaced by E. E is directly proportional to L. Now this is our principle of potentiometer. I go for solution. I don't take given things. Everything will be available in the problem only. We know that from the principle of potentiometer, V is directly proportional to L or E is directly proportional to L. Because potential difference is measured in terms of volt. EMF is also measured in terms of volt. Similar quantities can be compared according to the principle of homogeneity from the first year. So, shall I write? E1 is directly proportional to L1 and E2 is directly proportional to L2. Therefore, E2 by E1 is equals to L2 by L1 because I need E2, second cell. Shall I make it E2 equals to E1 into L2 by L1? This is my answer. EMF of the first cell, E1, its corresponding length, L1. EMF of the second cell, E2, corresponding length, L2. Everything will be given in the problem. Just substitute it neatly. What is E1? 1.25. What is L2? 63. Centimeter, centimeter, get cancelled, length, ratio. Then it is 35. So, when you go for calculation and do the necessary calculation with what? 1.25 multiplied by 63 divided by 35, it gives 2.25. Right? Check it. Is it possible to do without calculator? Just check it. Right? Is it clear? With the help of the calculator, you may get 1.25 multiplied with 63 divided by 35, it gives what? 2.25 volt. What is the EMF of the second cell? 2.25 volt. As the EMF increases, its balancing length is also increases, E2 is directly proportional to L2. So 1.25. When the balancing length 35 is increased to 63 cm, automatically it indirectly tells that you are obtaining EMF should be greater than 1.25 volt. Your answer is less than 1.25 volt. Somewhere else you have done the mistake while doing the calculation. That should be verified. Because the relation itself is establishing. What is that relation establishment? E2 is directly proportional to L2. As the length increases from 35 cm to 63 cm, naturally EMF must be greater than what? 1.25. So now this is our answer. Is it clear? Yes. So this is a simple problem. Shall I go for next? Shall I go for 10th problem? Yes, 10th problem. Now this is important problem. It is, I think that in previous year repeated. 10th problem. What the 10th problem tells? The number density of free electrons in a copper. The number density of free electrons in the number density of free electrons in copper conductor. In copper conductor. In copper conductor. Estimated. Measured. Estimated. At estimated as 8.5 into 10 to the power of, so because of the lesser intensity of it, I have to go with exposing the things with the proper illumination. 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28 per cubic meter. Full stop. How long does an electron? How long does an electron? How long does an electron take to drift? Take to drift. Take to drift from one end of a wire. From one end of a wire. From one end of a wire. 3 meter long. Not centimeter, meter. 3 meter long. To its other end. To its other end. Question 1. The area of cross section of the wire is, he has given area. The area of cross section. The area of cross section of the wire is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meters square. 2 into 10 to the power of, no, it is minus 6 meters square. And it is carrying a current of 3 ampere. And it is carrying a current of, it is carrying a current of 3 ampere. Now this is our problem. Right. Just you glance the problem. What he has given in the problem? The number density of electrons in a copper conductor estimated as 8.5 into 10 to 18 per cubic meter. How long does an electron take to drift from one end of a wire 3 meter long to its other end? Then he has given the area of cross section of the wire is 2 into 10 to 6 meter square and it is carrying a current of 3 ampere. How long? How long is nothing but time factor. So he has given the number density of the charges. There are so many number of free electrons available in the conductors. Then the total number of electrons per unit volume, that is nothing but small m. Now these are the number of electrons per unit volume. That is nothing but he has given small m. While solving the problem, we are given the equation. Current in terms of drift velocity. Before deriving this condition, we have got one more equation. The total charge, Q equals to NaLe. Total charge, Q equals to NaLe. So, Q equals to N into E. Right? So, our aim is to calculate. What is that? Time factor. What are the given things? Shall I write clearly here? The number of electrons, number density, N equals to 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28 electrons per cubic meter. The length of the wire is 3 meters. And area of cross section A equals to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meters square. And it is carrying a current of 3 ampere. Then what is the time factor? Right? Then what is the formula to be used? What is the formula to be used? Just to see the things, then you can easily come across what. total charge shall I take trying Q equals to NaL, but I need the time factor, I equals to Q by T, shall I take T equals to Q by I, shall I write NaLe divided by I. Otherwise, we go for one more equation, drift velocity. Drift velocity equals to naivadi Na into Vd. I equals to, that is I equals to Na into Vd. Then Vd is nothing but velocity, distance by time. Time t equals to Na Le divided by I. Is it the same thing? You go with either of the equation that is left to you. You can follow this equation or this equation. Both are same. Is it clear? That is left to you. We know that total charge in the conductor, I, NaL. What is the current? I equals to Q by T. Then T equals to Q by I. So what is Q? NaL divided by I. If you go with relation between current and drift velocity, you can use this equation also. That is left to you. Now, choice left, that is left to you. Sir, हमको कौन सा याद रहता है वो हम कर लेते हैं. आप ये याद है, ये इक्वेशन आप यूज कर सकते हैं. नहीं सर, हमको जल्दी, ये जल्दी से मालूम हो जाता. I equals to nine होती, velocity is nothing but meter per second, that is nothing but length by time. Right? L by T. Then the time t. Well, then you simply go for substitution. Shall I take this equation? Both are same. Then substitute. Therefore, t equals to n 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28. Area 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Length 3 meter. Charge of the electron 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 9. That should be given. E should be considered. That should not, so certain constant factors are not provided in the problem. Now these are the constant factors. They have to be substituted from your side. Sir, E nahi diye so hum kya karna? Nahi dete ho. Because constant factors are never be mentioned in the problem. That should be understood and you have to be substituted from your side. Then what is that current? 3. These are the answers. Then T equals 8.5 into 2, how much? 17 into 1.6 into 90, minus 19 minus, minus 6 minus 25 minus 25 plus 28 plus 3. Right? Shall I write this is nothing but 17 into 16 into 10 to the power of minus 1. Otherwise, you go for 17 into 1.6 multiplied 10 to the power of plus 3. After doing the calculation with calculator, 17 into 1.6 that provides. So I go for, it is simplified of 17 into 16 10 to the power of minus 1. Minus 1 plus 3 plus 2. Is it clear? Right? Then I go for 16 into 17 into 16. Right? So 17 into 16, I go for simple calculation, 17 into 16. That is 42, 4, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 7, 1, 2, 7, 272. So how many places I have? 272 into 10 to the power of 2. 272 into 10 to the power of 2. Simply I can write. Shall I make it? T equals to 272 into 10 to the power of 2. I shift the 2 position 2.72. Then this becomes what? 10 to the power of 4 seconds. This is nothing but calculate. Without need of the calculator. Just check the equation. Right? Now these are the problems. we come across that next study we have done the 6 problems. They are the somewhat easier comparing to today's problems. Today's problems are somewhat lengthy. They take some more time for writing rather than solving the problem. The writing the problem takes the so many lines compared with what? Solution. Solution is easier than what? The problem. Simply we have to be. Remember the equation I have given the hint, the total charge in the conductor Na, the current NaNe. Then current equals to I equals to Q by T. I need the time factor T, Q by I. Substitute the values. Without going for the calculator, the simplest way, 17 into 16 is nothing but 272 into 10 to the power 2. I want to write in terms of decimal point, that is 2.72. I have shifted the two digits here. I have to take 10 to the power of how much? 2 here extra, that is 10 to the power of 4. Now this is your answer. Now this is the time required for the electron to cross one end to another end. The remaining problem, the last, that is nothing but in the next class. I think that next class, it completes almost all your NSAT exercise. Is it clear? Okay. Thank you.